Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, 'cause I always wanted me one that was long and black.
One best time to work out in 1951 Chevy Woody Wagon with a 350 small block with a T5 fairing on it. Headset frame.
I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime.
We're right here, we're working on better plans, and it's gonna go on the motor, and I'm all the lights on the front, and the fire. Now I'm just drilling out the hole. Design needs on CAD.
I left that day with a lunchbox full of gear. I've never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. The first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I got me an engine and a trunk, then I got me a transmission and all the chrome. The little things I could get in my big lunch.
I'm putting in the floor pan on the 51 Chevy. We channeled the floor 2 inches and we're making the floor fit on the nest end right now.
Something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53 and the motor turned out to be a 73. And when we tried to put in the bolts, all the holes were gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with a little bit of help from an adapter kit, we had that engine running just like a song. Now the headlights, there was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right, but when we pulled out the switch, all three of them come on. The back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together, and when we got through, well, that's when we noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time, my wife walked out, and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts. But she opened the door and said, "Honey, take me for a spin." So we drove uptown just to get the tags.
I put the cars, we're doing right now, we're putting in the floors, getting that all situated so we don't fall through and go Flintstone mode. And then we're trying to get the shaft all cleaned up so we can get it running and driving pretty soon. Yeah, Tony behind us is working on the steering column so we can steer it. And then you got Johannes over there, he's working on the exhaust system. And yeah, that's what we got on so far.
Yeah, Red Rider, this is the Cottonmouth in the Psycho Billy Cadillac. Come on. Haul. This is a Cottonmouth, and negatory on the cost of this machine there, Red Rider. You might say I went right up to the factory and picked it up. It's cheaper that way. What model is it? Well, it's a 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59 automobile. It's a 60, 61, 62, 63.